You see the current state of affairs? No, I did not try to make pink lemonade land. This is just how much it took me before I found where that last stage was located. All the time. Whenever there's one left to find, you can never find it. Hey everybody, it's Chugga Conroy. Welcome back to more Splatoon. Last time, we tried to beat people up using a squirt bottle, and it went marginally better than you would expect. Yeah, I'll go with that. This time, we find ourselves with an unidentified flying object. Trouble over Inkopolis. Da-da-da-da-da! Your friendly neighborhood power plant employee at your service. But not really, because our new feature this time around is yet another amiibo figure. Inkling Boy. There are two varieties of this figure. They're both functionally the same, just like you got with the squid. Sup, playa. Thanks a ton for calling me up. I heard you've been making waves around the city. And I've got an inkling that you're the type of inkling who's up for a challenge. Want to give one of my roller challenges a go? I heard you've been doing work in Octo Valley. Wearing that crazy getup, wrecking Octo Bros and junk. That's when I knew for sure you've got what it takes to try my challenges. All you've got to do is beat those same missions using a roller weapon. So are you game? I've got some dope rewards lined up if you can. I am so lame. I'm not even going to try. Okay. So the stage that we were going to be playing, unidentified flying object, trouble over Inkopolis. Yeah. All that saving heroic junk. Inkling Boy, unlike the squid, will not have different varieties of challenges for you. It's just simply that you play the stage with the hero roller instead of the hero shot. So we'll go into the stage playing it as if it is our first time. The Hero Roller is what we're equipped with this time. It is identical in stats to the regular Splat Roller. It's much like how the Hero Shot at level 1 is the same as a Splatter Shot. And, we're getting introduced to our bad guy this time already. This is an Octo Striker. As the name implies, yep, he can use Ink Strikes. However, he can only use Ink Strikes. It's located on that UFO over there. Yeah, you can see him. He just jumped up, which probably means that, yep, an Ink Strike's headed our way any second. But good thing, I'm a roller. I can just roll right out of the way. Pointless squeegees. Better than, I almost said pointful squeegees, but that's not a word. You know what I mean. We gotta teach him a lesson, though. We gotta let him know, hopefully with not the help of a very long and annoying bio to edit, that fighting using only an Ink Strike is very inefficient. So we'll teach him a very important life lesson as when we get over there. I'm gonna grab this armor, and this place should be looking awfully familiar to you. Yeah, it's the tutorial area. So if you ever wanted to revisit this place, you don't need to even delete your save data in order to do it. All you need is just decent story progress in Octo Valley, which I guess depending on how much you've played, maybe deleting your save data would actually be the more efficient way, but I don't know. I'm just trying to be all inclusive. All right, so he will not target. Didn't even know you were there. Such a satisfying kill. He will not be able to target you with an Ink Strike unless he knows where you are. You gotta be making ripples when you're swimming. You gotta pop out of your swim for a little bit. You gotta be in kid form. Something of that nature. This stage is excellent at showing you the rules as to when people can see you and when they can't. Also, that box would have been a sunken scroll if we were playing in Octo Valley. Because when you're swimming on the ground, if you're swimming at less than 70% of full speed, you will not make any ripples, and nobody can see you. You are completely invisible. It is slower than if you were to swim at full speed with Ninja Squid, even with the movement penalty that Ninja Squid gives you on equipment, but it's just kind of something nice. If you were to swim on a wall, I should show this. It is impossible to not make ripples. Even if you're trying to swim as slow as you can and just maintain your position, you will always make ripples on a wall, so it's less reliable there. I can't actually use my seekers right now because we're in an amiibo challenge. Oh, well, I can just fling my roller at you. This place is the reason why I wanted to do this particular challenge with a roller. Yeah, they're hidden all over the place, and it can be a little bit challenging to go through here with just a roller by your side. You do have your splat bombs, which are nice, of course, but that's really all you get for added help, and it's not good for much of anything other than dowsing. I say that as I kill a guy with one of them. You take that, you take that. Wow, this is kind of easy. Well, okay. For those of you that wanted to see me get challenged a lot, I got good news for you. This is not the only place that is difficult to play with a roller, nor is it the only reason that I wanted to do this. Just a big one. Do that. Let's go tutorial on its ass. Don't read too into that. Believe it or not, that oh gosh was not directed at the ink strike. It was the fact that I'm having to climb a squeegee wall with nothing but a roller and splat bombs, but it went easier than I thought. You were doing a terrible job cleaning up. You should die. And now we hop on this and see a bit of Inkopolis, the actual city. And now we're up on the UFO. Your time has come. I shall explain you to death. The Octostriker has a near endless supply of octocopters. I say near endless because it goes on for a few minutes before you kill all of them and they stop respawning. You can just keep going around in circles, for there are fish eggs to be obtained, and we want that for our equipment. We have some armor. I think I'm just gonna try to outlast this as much as I can. Do that. Hit you. Hit you too. Still going. You. Hi. Just gotta keep on moving. That situation right there. If he would have launched an ink strike at me, I might have actually been in trouble. Is that all of them? Wow. Okay. You. Die in one hit to my roller. We gotta do more of these amiibo challenges. They aren't really so challenging. Grab our derpy looking plush, and there we go. Bow, 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 bow. Oh snap, you rocked that challenge. Here's your loot. If there's anything else to say about the Inkling Boy amiibo, is that here is the equipment you can get should you clear all of its challenges. You can play just as many stages as you could with the Inkling Squid, with 23 new challenges made available to you. And when going over the different colors, something that I want to point out that I think is really neat is the fact that not only are they different ink colors, not only do they have different skin pigments and different eyes, which are customization options you can actually have in the game, but even though the figure is the same, the two Inkling boys are wearing different equipment on each set. Not only that, but the purple one has a Tenetech splatter shot, while the blue just has a regular splatter shot. It's a nice little detail. It's one little extra stamp added to whatever was painting these things, but I think it goes a long way, and it's kind of nice that whenever they made alternate versions, they actually gave them Tenetex. Heck, he's holding one in-game right now. Our Sunken Scroll says, it seems that some Octarians can assume humanoid form. These species have superior physical capabilities and are highly aggressive. High-ranking individuals have kelp on their heads. But what motivates them, if anything at all? Itri-o-si-ita. That's what I think the top says. Octolings are cool. And I want to eat those octopi forms just so, so much. They look delicious. I want to eat them so much. But this gives a little bit of foreshadowing if you can pry your eyes away from that for just a moment. Because we have not seen kelp octolings up to this point. Kind of showing that there's going to be some stronger varieties that we have yet to see. Also, for the record, I don't discriminate, because I gotta be honest, I want to eat myself too. I look delicious as a squid. Don't lie. You want it. You so do. Before this goes any more awry, let's just go to Inkopolis Plaza and not hop off of it this time and just go in. That is all for Octo Valley, and that is all for Daniel Post, who's apparently a cat. It's also all for the special new thing. So, how about now we do what we always do when we're down in Octo Valley and beyond, and get to talking to the fat cat that I didn't talk to last time. Cover the ground with ink to fill your special gauge. Yes, yes, we already know this one. That was a pretty normal one. Okay. The weapon of the day. Once again, we've gone a whole one video without a new weapon class? Can't have that, so answering the call this time is the Heavy Splatling. Splatling guns are modified chargers in that their charge duration determines the length of continuous fire rather than range and damage. Most rules that apply to chargers will also apply here, such as charges being slower while jumping and wanting to aim your shots high because they're very long range. But the big difference that sets this apart and makes it its own weapon class, other than charging continuous fire instead of just one big shot, is that Splatlings have constant range no matter how long their charge has gone on for. Partial charges are instrumental to playing this weapon, and close combat is more viable here than it is for snipers. The Heavy Splatling has ludicrously high firing rate and some of the best range of any non-charger. In fact, it outranges every single shooter out there. Another big difference is the laser aim assist on chargers is not present here whatsoever. You don't need to worry about your enemy being able to see that, even though you have huge range. True to its name, it weighs down the user a lot in terms of movement speed. In terms of damage, all Splatlings have equal damage to the Splattershot Jr., so it takes anywhere from 4 to 5 hits to splat, depending on your enemy's defense. Because of this, don't always wait for a 100% charge. If you're stuck at close range, charging even 1/4 of the maximum can be enough to take out an enemy. It may have the ability to charge up, but that doesn't mean it should be played like a charger. It's very much its own separate thing. Its sub is the splash wall. This is your best friend. I'm sorry for your apparently pitiful existence. Use this a lot in narrow hallways or when forced to fight up close. It buys more than enough time for a sufficient charge even when it's being shot at. Special is Ink Strike. In addition to the more basic uses, it can flush out potential targets from a really good distance and force them to fight you when a splash wall is already prepared. It's one of the few weapons where I would say an Ink Strike actually has a practical fighting use other than just simply being a defensive or a support option. Here's your equipment recommendations. Nothing really too all out of the ordinary. I think we've been over pretty much all these abilities at this point and you'd understand why I'd suggest them. I like to think of the Heavy Splatling as a gateway charger. Personally, I don't enjoy playing chargers hardly at all, but I enjoy the Heavy Splatling and I can get the hang of it. I think that if you want to get into playing chargers, this is a great weapon to practice with. On to the next kit, the more star-studded roll, Heavy Splatling Deco. Same stats, but it has medium special depletion. Sub is the point sensor. Coupled with the long range and incomplete charges still being enough to kill, this is one of the best sets to have point sensors. Its special is the Kraken. Heavy Splatling is pretty decent at covering turf for a weapon that needs to charge, so it will get this a fair amount. This is for two things: emergencies when someone approaches you with no time to charge, and in situations where invincibility will aid you in reaching a place that will help you play your distance. Also, throwing a point sensor, then using Kraken is a great combo. Don't forget you have it. It's a seriously underrated combo that not many people talk about, but it's so good. And onto the third is a Sheldon's pick unlocked at level 20, Heavy Splatling Remix. Same stats, but with light special depletion yet again. Its sub is the Sprinkler, and its special is the Killer Whale. This might seem like a strange combination, but I like to call it flexible. The Killer Whale is the cheapest special in the game, and the Sprinkler makes it even more affordable. The set will get its special all the time, almost to the point of using this kit being centered around using the Killer Whale. And this makes it very good in Rainmaker and Tower Control. It's not terrible in Splat Zones either, thanks to the Sprinkler combined with the long firing range of the main gun. Try using it with these things in mind. The map rotation is about to look awfully familiar because I'm recording this the same night as our last adventure out into Turf Wars. Why am I doing this? Because I like Walleye Warehouse, and I like this weapon, and I'd like to actually show off some nice shooting on it, unlike what we did with the Squiver, so we're giving it another shake. If you run out from behind the crates all willy-nilly, you're gonna get splatted. Yup, I like to hide for a bit and catch my breath. No, I didn't forget. Stay fresh! Now let's go. I consider the Heavy Splatling to be my personal best weapon. I like it, I play it a lot, my friends agree that I'm most dangerous when I have it, so this one meant a lot to me. I like all three of the sets. I've played all three sets a fair amount, and my decision for which kit I was gonna play did not come lightly, which is why I'm playing the fresh Squiffer. No. I like the vanilla Heavy Splatling a lot, and even though I do think the remix might have been the best for what the current map rotation is, I think I just want to play the vanilla this time purely out of liking it. It does a pretty good job doing lane control because of its range and its splash wall. The remix would have done the same with its killer whale, but I just think that this is going to be the best for how I personally play. In the way of equipment, I put a lot of slots into special charge up. I think the shirt and shoes complement one another pretty well on that, just so I can get my special built up all the time. Ink Recovery Up might be good, Ink Saver Main might, it's only one spot of it though, so probably only gonna give me like one extra bullet. Run speed up, swim speed up. I don't know if run speed up's gonna help me terribly much. Actually, you know what? I think I'm gonna change my equipment really quick. Let's go with that. I think that might help me a little bit better. Probably gonna get some help at the ink resist up whenever I'm playing my distance and just trying to space myself apart from enemies. The one sub of damage up probably isn't gonna do a dang thing for me, but I think I'd rather have that than just be wishy-washy about what shoes I'm gonna wear. Here's what I'm looking like. If I weren't wearing those hideous shoes with this shirt, I might actually look pretty decent. In what just seems like daily routine at this point, we had two games get decided by disconnects that I cut out, the first of which was in my favor, the other was in the other team's favor. It evened out. I'm okay. I'm not angry about that. I'm not bitter. Let's just do this. Got a good mix of long and short range in both teams. I think I'm just gonna hang back, play support, outrange the people with short range in the other team, use splash walls to approach the people that are long range, get stuck on a corner somehow that I can't explain. I guess maybe it was that little bit of a lip. Turn that down, and yeah. Gonna be using splash walls a lot, gonna be playing lane control, and I can't talk about the heavy splatling without mentioning what it was like pre-nerf. For those that don't know, the splash wall, integral part of playing this kit, got a really heavy nerf after a while. It used to not take nearly as much damage from enemy attacks, so it would take a lot longer to destroy and you'd get a lot more mileage out of it no matter what your enemy was doing. They increased it so that it takes, I think, 1.4 times the amount of damage that it used to. It's ridiculous just how resilient it used to be compared to what it is now. They also made it so that the ink recovery lag after you lay it down is longer. So there's also that. And then splash walls, if you threw them on an upward slope, they used to deploy instantly. There was no waiting for them to pop up like that. Now they'll do it on any surface though, but before, laying it on a slope was a very good tip and you'd be able to take great advantage of that by just having an instant shield. Even though it did hurt it quite a lot, I still love the heavy splatling anyway. I made it before the nerf, I still made it after the nerf. I like it just that much. The range is great, everything. Wow, that guy was just a carbon roller. Couldn't find the words right there. Kept wanting to say Koro Koro roller. It's just, they both begin with C-O and they both end with roller. It's a little bit difficult. Knew you were hiding right there. Oh god, this is where the sniper is, isn't it? Those long trails of ink are kind of tipping me off. You are just sitting there, dude. You can go onward. I'm giving you an ink strike, giving you a splash wall, giving you all the help that I can give other than shooting in your general. That got a kill, wow. Didn't think it wasn't such an open area, but hey. Even though I'm tagged, just gonna take care of this ink, try to make it so nobody can get close to me. I think we got it pretty much in the bag at this point. What is it with that corner? Every time I say anything remotely confident and I'm near that corner, just nope. There's the right side peeking, and you over there. Hi. Oh, whoa. Actually, he's using Koro Koro equipment. No wonder I thought he was Koro Koro. I just did the most pointless super jump in the world. Maybe it shaved off 4 frames or something of that effect. Kind of doing that so we'll think that I'm back there and I can approach from this side. I like faking like that. Oh boy. That carbon roller is trying to keep me back. I think he's dead. 17 seconds left. Peek out, throw that. Protect it. Nope. Couldn't protect my teammates. We had it and we lost it. 4, 3, 2, 1. Your explosion didn't hit me in the face after the time limit, thanks to my splash wall placement. Ah, well. If ever there was a game that perfectly illustrates that everything just gets decided in the last 30 seconds, this is it. I think my stats at least look nice. 4 kills, 2 deaths, 601 turf covered with a charging weapon. Not gonna complain about that, that's alright. Well, we'll get him on Walleye Warehouse. On to smaller and better things. And it's the very next game. Our luck is a-turning. I like the green that we are. It's like a shamrock shake or something like that. Ah, oh, it's so delicious. Got 2 Splattershot Juniors. I saw an E-Leader in there. I think the last one was a roller, but I'm not 100% sure on that. Oh, looks like a dynamo roller. Yep, that's definitely a dynamo roller. Always look ahead, always try to see what your enemy's got. That can be information that's helpful to you all in and of itself. Even if you only know the main weapon, you don't know the sub combination yet. Always look out for that kind of thing. You can shield me, and you can get hit by 2 of my bullets, but not all 5. Sure. Go over this way. You're supporting me pretty nicely right there. I think that's the tempered dynamo roller, which would be why those seekers are coming out right there. I don't think anything else on their team can have that in any sets. I think I know his kit now. Gonna go back and let's pressure their sniper. Get him off of that perch, hopefully. I think I might have actually mistapped. Yeah, looks like I did. Crud. It's no matter. We can build it up again. It's still good. Nobody's paying any attention to me. I'm just kind of off in my own little corner. Let's toss down another wall. That was a cool bounce right there. That helped me a lot. Double kill with one charge. Yes, saw it and I went for it. Was trying to lay down a splash wall to protect that guy so he could jump in just fine. That's another good use for him, is just using him to support your team in that way. I think they're just about all back there, so let's pressure. That was an atrocious throw. I would make the red versus blue reference, but I already did that earlier. You guys, you can get down from there. They really don't have a way of approaching us too easy, do they? Dynamo's up there, but I don't see much of any way that he can get close to me. You're not the dynamo, so it didn't count as jinxing it. Just saying, you gotta be the one that I said it to for it to count. It doesn't necessarily count if you're not. Oh! Wore off. If it wore off just 1 second earlier, didn't have any. And they did have special duration up. That special duration up saved your ass. Don't tell me it didn't, because it did. That thing helped you so much, and wow, for playing my main weapon, we sure are having a lot of losses. Maybe that person that told me that I would make a really good charger wasn't kidding. Maybe this is the sign because I had wins on the charger video. You can go that way, you can go over here. Your ink strike might be what we need in this situation. Let's get it back, let's get our ink strike off. I probably should have done this a second later. Holy crap, I didn't die there! No, not gonna do it. I thought the time limit was almost over. I don't know how I possibly thought that. I looked up and I saw like 20 and I'm like, oh, what? Where? Why are they still big on the top? Like, we're covering up so much of their ink and they have like nothing left. You're out of ink. I can approach you. Rush you. Get a kill. No. I don't think I played too terra bad, but... Ouch. That wasn't even... I think that was even more crushing than the first one. They didn't get as many points, but we got less. What's it looking like? Oh, I was number one. Got 4 kills, 1 death. I almost had the most kills of anyone in the game. I'm not hurting over that too badly. There's games where you play well, but you just don't win. I got some good shots there. I was proud of that 2-1 right there. I kind of want to play again, but maybe we'll revisit it some other time. Besides, I got to become a Shamrock Shake. That's a pretty darn good day. All right, Judd, you got any pick-me-up words after such a terrible defeat? You got anything for me? Because I lost both matches with my main. That's a pretty rotten day. Only your warm and fuzziness can cheer me up. Meow. A splat bomb's timer is only active while it's on the ground. It'll explode quicker when rolled than when launched through the air. I'll just pretend that's you calling me the bomb and call it a day. All right. So, that is all for now. Next time on Splatoon, we're going to be looking at an invention that everyone needs in their life. See you guys then. We'll be right back.